tell me your craziest farm story. I'll go first. So I was dating this girl one time, and her family owned a farm. And they went away for the weekend, so they were like, hey, can y'all look after the animals and feed them and stuff? And we were like, yeah, we'll boot scoot buggy our way over there right now. And so it's like 6 a.m., and I go, and she's like, I'm going to feed the horses, you feed the chickens. I'm like, simple, easy, they're so cute, right? No, I'm feeding these chickens. I look around the corner, a rooster staring at me like this. And I'm like, okay, I don't know why we got beef. I didn't think this was a cow farm. Anyway, so it starts sprinting after me, and I'm like, okay, back up. But I started sprinting too, because you're not going to catch me slipping. And so I'm screaming, and my ex goes, drop the bucket, but it's in the distance. So I thought she said, drop that mother. So I turn around, and I kick it like a 60-yard field goal in the Super Bowl, right? But I kicked it so hard, I thought I killed it. I swear to God, I thought it was instant contact dead. But I kicked it. The whole time it's in the air, it's looking at me like this. And then as soon as it hits the ground, it comes back after me. Yeah!
I just realized that if you're the type of person who used to call their parent to come pick them up at a sleepover before you had even slept yet, then you're the type of person who drives separately to the events from your friends just in case you want to dip early. So it's me, but... smoking something much lighter. She asked me if I do this every day, I said often.
That's how many times you up the wave, not so often. Fit check, the dogs are out. Who let the...
There is one thing that I will not argue about in this world, and it's that we do not know colors. Here, and before you say, take your medicine, no, just listen to me. From birth, people have told us, they have, like, put in our heads that the ocean is blue. So no matter what color that we see, we're gonna label it as blue. Do you hear what I'm saying? Or the sky, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not saying that there's different colors. I'm saying that, like, if I see it as purple, I still label it as blue because people tell me that the sky is blue or the ocean is blue. And here's my thing too, is you can say, Allie, that's wrong, but it's not, because the only way that you can describe, I'm stuttering because I'm passionate, not because I'm incapable. The only way that you can describe a color to me is by saying a different item is a color or by describing it with another color.
Akon said, I'm trying to find the words to describe this girl without being disrespectful. And then followed it with, damn, she's a sexy bitch. You're 100%, you're trying.
Louisiana people are just born different. Let me tell you why. When I first moved to Louisiana, one of my buddies invited me out to their house on the bayou and was like, we're gonna go boating this weekend, you should come. And so I was like, okay, sounds like a good time. We get out there, they start jumping in the water. I look not 20 feet from me, there's an alligator. And I'm like, guys, you gotta get out of the water right now. Caution, 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 caution. And they're like, no, Allie, it won't bother you unless you bother it. Did he tell you that? Because I don't trust him right now. He's smiling at me and his teeth look sharp. Anyway, so then I don't get in because I was not born that way. Lady Gaga lied. Anyways, so we go tubing. My feet are on the tube like this, but they're born different. So we are going around these turns in the tube. 80 miles per hour. I'm holding on for dear life. I'm holding on so tight. It's like a girl in a toxic relationship. She just won't let go. I fell off. Y'all need to come get me. I'm in the water like this. Help! Hi. Good morning, Fit Check. I woke up this morning mad at lactose intolerant people because I think they're weak. And you might say, Allie, who are you? And I don't really know anybody who's lactose intolerant, but I just know that there's a lot of things in the world that I don't want to tolerate. But you don't call me, like, you're bullshit intolerant. You know what I'm saying? Also, I think it's weak because it's like you have one drop of a milkshake. Oh, get into it. And then all of a sudden your bunghole turns into a human trumpet. I don't get that. Seems childish. Seems a little bit immature. I think there's people who are tolerating cancers, and I think there's people who are even worse, tolerating Libras, and like you want to sit here and tell me you can't handle a little bit of milk. What did cows do to you? Move over. I'm lactose intolerant. I don't get it. I think it's dramatic. When I was in the fifth grade, I wanted to play the drums, but they said I had to play the trombone, and then people called me tromboner, so I quit. There's plenty worth quitting today, guys.
Fit check. Guys, today I'm thinking about the time I went to the zoo and I saw a giraffe give birth and everyone's like, oh, that's super beautiful. No, there's a lot of trauma in that situation. First off, you have to think about a giraffe. Like if it's 15 feet tall, right? And so it's giving birth,
But, like, that baby has to drop 10 feet, but in that, you're, like, fresh out the womb. Imagine being fresh out the womb. You get dropped 200 feet. I was worried. That baby giraffe drops out of that mom, and it looks like this. And then it tries to, everyone's like, oh, and I'm like, baby, get up. You can do it, right? The giraffe starts walking like this. Somebody help, y'all are like clapping. You need to call an EMT right now. It broke everything in that big spine. You need to call somebody. That is concussion. Anyway.
Hi, I don't consider myself a religious person, but if they would have said a woman instead of amen, I might have gotten on my knees. I might have gotten into it a little bit. Is that fucked up to say? Can I say that? Am I saying?
The more and the more I think about cats, the more I understand them. Because you know what? Meow too. I'm in pain too. I get that.
There's a lot of things in life that I do, and I don't know why I do them, but I do them and I can't stop doing them, even though they make sense. Do you think she does them? Yeah, probably. Anyways, like today I was taking a test, and I was sitting there and I didn't know the answer, and so I just closed my eyes. And I was like, give me a sign. I don't know if that's spiritual, anxious, ADHD, or hell, maybe I'm a future ghost whisperer and I'm just thinking we're vibing, me and the ghost. Hey, Casper, what's up? Let's get into it. But I'll just close my eyes and I'll look for a sign. And it'll be the most random sign. Like, I'll hear a chair move and I'll be like, chair does start with C, so it must be C. Bitch, you will do anything besides study. It's like, can you just study? Can we just open the book? You know what I'm saying? Like, will you just like put in a little hard work? You know, no, I won't. I'll rub crystals on my titties. That's what my studying is. I'm like, if it's meant to be, it'll be. Calm down, Florida Georgia Line. You know, I don't know why I am the way I am, but I'm here and I'm queer. It's a party. Not good at their jobs. I'm gonna give you three examples. My buddy calls me last night and he goes, Allie, I was on the phone with the suicide hotline last night. Back up! Are you okay? And second off, how did you get to the number? Did you Google it? And he's like, no, I was laying in bed and I said, hey Alexa, how many ibuprofen would it take to no longer be alive? And instead of doing her job, which she's programmed to do, she snitched and called the suicide hotline. That's number one. Do your job. Number two, he's on the suicide hotline call and he's like, I'm talking to this guy for like 20 minutes about my depression. And the guy goes, hey buddy, if you're not gonna kill yourself, I'm gonna get off of here. You're being paid to care. Imagine like somebody doesn't even care about you enough to stay on the phone and they're being paid to do it. Some people don't deserve $15 an hour. I mean, come on. And number three, and I'm not gonna explain this one, fathers. Thank you. I was just taking the trash out and I was like, I was kind of getting a little hustle with it, right? And then I started thinking, do you hear the amount of birds right now? Everybody wants that's fan behavior. Anyways, and I was thinking about how quick Miley was making me feel when she said, zigzag across the floor. Why are we going so fast? I was always in a rush. Zigzag across the floor, shuffle all right now? That's like 3 seconds. I'm like, and then the thing is too, is she said, if you're 5 or 82, this is something you can do. Grandma cannot zigzag that fast. This is what the kids were like. And then you got grandma. By the time, I've already got my hand on my, I'm doing a 180 by the time grandma has even shuffled. 5 or 82, my ass. 5 to 30 would have been more appropriate. Miley. When Noah Sauer said, I've done a lot of things wrong, I said, I don't know if I felt that one. But then she followed it with loving you being one. And I said, yeah, you got me there. Maybe I am guilty. You know, I don't know if it's that's necessarily on me, but maybe we could get a little list going. Hell, maybe it is July. Obviously you got all the answers, Noah. And I bet a lot of people are super pumped up because Joe Biden's in office now, and me too, but it kind of feels like when somebody gets out of a super crappy relationship and gets into a new one, and the new person just treats them like with human decency and like isn't a total like piece of crap, and people are like, yes! It's like, why are we clapping for people who literally do the bare minimum? Is that where we're at in life? That like somebody just isn't like a complete crap person and we're like, that's good shit right there! Give me some
more of that. Like, can we tip our toes into the water? You know, see if we like it. Can we even swim?
ADHD plus anxiety is like the funnest and freshest little combo, because I was just sitting here, enjoying tea. And I was like, oh my gosh, my mom did such a good job with these curtains. Like, this room looks amazing. I love her. And then my mom was like, what if she said, what? I just got off the phone with her 5 minutes ago. My mind's like, a lot can happen in 5 minutes. I'm just saying, I don't want to. Justin Bieber said never say never, and I just listened to it. No, I didn't even like that song that much. You know, anxiety is like that friend. I have a cold. Brr, it's cold in here. There must be anxiety in the atmosphere. Okay, anyways, anxiety is like that friend who's like comes to you with news and they're like, oh my God, guess what I found out? And you're like, what? And they're like, never, I shouldn't have said anything. That's on me. Sorry, I shouldn't have said anything. Don't think about it. I'm looking for a woman named Bob. Hopefully she can fix me.